Podcasterize! Hello everyone, and welcome to Lost in Applationmon, episode 47. I'm May.
And I'm Jay.
And this time we watched Digimon Universe, Appli Monsters, episode 47, The Truth About Eugene. What were your favourite bits?
Okay, I'm going to open with my favourite bit was right at the end when they did the big reveal and you went,
Okay, so, I mean, obviously, this is a full spoilery discussion of Appmon, so just heads up.
What else could it possibly be?
So, when Eugene says to Shutmon, kill him, I, for some reason, thought he was saying kill Haru. Like, instead of kill him, he's referring to Haru and not Bootmon, which would make sense, and that's what he's talking about. So, I thought he was going to kill Haru.
That's, like, a completely nonsense conclusion to come to.
I know, but that's my thought.
Because he and Haru had been on that rooftop alone for like 4 hours.
Yes, I know, but I don't know. Okay, yeah, I know. If
you can just admit
this,
that it was really dumb.
It is really dumb. I fully admit that it was really dumb. But my reaction was 100% based on the fact that I, for some reason, thought that he was going to kill Haru, because the whole time in the episode, I was like, is Eugene going to push him off the roof or like stab him in a dark alleyway or something? Like, that was what I was worried about happening the whole episode. And the whole episode, like, for the episode to be called The Truth About Eugene, I thought it would just be about Eugene.
Yeah, but then again, the episode that was entitled the like second great Appmon games or whatever was not all about that. So
yeah, it was about Hajime, yeah.
You know that that's not how these work. And sure, I would have also liked it to be the explanation about Eugene, but that wasn't. It's just the truth. And you got the truth, right?
Mm.
It's like saying, did you kill this person? The person goes, yes. Okay, well, you want to know why'd you do it, when'd you do it, with what, the whole details. But you know, you got the truth. It's still the truth.
Mm. Maybe it's because I hyped myself up for this episode too much. Like, we're watching it early because I didn't want to be spoiled. And I feel like I put too much hope into this episode. And I feel like I shouldn't have done that, because now I'm just sort of disappointed. And I don't think I enjoyed the episode as much, because the whole time I was waiting for the truth of Eugene. And the whole time I was just wondering what it could be and wondering how serious it would be. And then in the last minute of the show, we get, oh, he's actually a robot designed by Leviathan, which we kind of already guessed. Like, that's not a big thing. We didn't get any big reveal. He didn't do anything particularly, like, terribly... I mean, I know he killed Bootmon, but...
Well, he turned him into a chip.
Well, he said kill him, but yeah, he turned him into a chip. And then he has another Appmon that's presumably the god level, and it's the one that's above Kiwami. But it's... I don't know, I didn't... I feel like I didn't enjoy this episode because I put too much expectations into this episode, and I feel like that's my own fault. It probably was an okay episode, but I can't actually think of anything but things that were my favorites. I can't think of any negatives either, though. I mean, it was an episode, but I mean the chasing Bootmon was okay, and I love Eri and I love Astra, but I just don't feel like there was much in this episode. I feel like I think it's just because I put too much expectation into this episode. I thought, oh yeah, this will be the top episode, this is going to dethrone episode 4. But it wasn't. It wasn't a bad episode. I just feel like it's like in the middle of my ranking. I haven't even worked out where to place it, because it wasn't terrible, but it wasn't like what I thought it would be. And I'm just disappointed.
And this is the entire problem with that Japanese, we don't care about spoilers culture.
Mm.
Because when you are told what is going to happen in the episode, and especially if it's something you want to happen.
Yeah.
You spend the entire episode waiting for it, and it's just not that. It becomes less interesting, especially the rest of it, because the rest of the episode was a glorified filler episode.
Oh, it was 100%, yeah, 100%, yeah. It was chasing Bootmon.
And we're going to chase him again, and he's going to get scared again, and then, oh, the twist this time is that they want to scare him so he doesn't get scared. Okay. And at the end of the day, what happens? Well, they have him there. And it just is what it is. And, you know, there are characters who are being smart. Like, Ray's obviously figured out his stuff. And Bootmon's funny. And, you know, it's got good bits to it. The Eri is too cute thing was the thing that scared Bootmon was kind of funny.
I feel like it could have been better with the fact it scared. Like, the face she made was, like, he thought it was terrifying.
No, I thought it'd be funny if... Yeah. He goes, it's too cute, and then Astra says, oh man, you made a terrifying face, because Astra has no empathy whatsoever.
Yeah.
Because he just does what entertains him.
Oh, no, I do remember a part that I thought was funny, that when they have the USB, and Gatchaman's like, oh, how do I use it? And Ray goes like this, and he drinks his little drink. I thought that was cute.
Choo.
And I love his fascination with the drink. I also like Haru's like, is ignorance the right word of how like he's been told that he should be careful about Yujin and
no,
he just disregards
it? No, that's a negative.
It.
We're going to get there.
Yeah.
If you want us no, to no, be in a proper segment.
Well, no, I'm just saying, well, it's not really, there are no segments in this. It's
there
just
are.
Like I mean, there's pacing to the episode, but I don't think that's necessarily a negative.
Oh, boy, is it.
It's his character.
No, it's a negative.
I feel like that's just his character is just like blindlessly saying, oh, yes, he's my best friend. Yujin's Yujin. Of course, he's fine. He's my best friend.
It doesn't go. You can't have a character say twice, look, I'm pretty sure there's something up with this guy. And then have the, and yeah, sure, he can say, you know, I trust him and I still think he's good, right?
Yeah.
Even though it's a total gut feeling. Oh. You do not get the right to have that character be totally shocked and surprised when he turns out to be wrong, though. Because he may as well not have been told.
I guess have him be a little bit wary. Oh, I just thought of a negative if you want to move on to negatives.
And I don't, especially if Ray thought this was the case, I thought he had planned something and it turned out he hadn't. Yeah. I thought, you know, you got two super geniuses doing stuff with this group, and if they've worked out that there's something up here, have a backup plan. Well, and they didn't.
Well, that's just the negative that I just thought of, and I guess we'll get to it now, is that why he's sending Bootmon to go to Haru and Yujin's location. If he doesn't trust Yujin, he should not have him anywhere near Bootmon. Because Ray is the one who's always thinking, yes, but Leviathan. And if he doesn't trust someone and someone's backstory is fabricated, and the bad guy you're fighting is Leviathan, you would say, Leviathan might have done this. Leviathan wants Bootmon. Let's keep Yujin away. Let's send Yujin off on a wild goose chase. Maybe Astra and Eri can do the whole chasing and the capturing of him. Send Haru and Yujin off somewhere else away because Haru will keep him. You don't have to tell Haru that he's just to keep Yujin occupied. But you want to keep Yujin as far away from Bootmon as possible.
If you have any suspicion that he might be not what you suspect, maybe don't put him near the mission critical Appmon.
Yeah, and I feel like, I don't know, this shouldn't happen. I feel like Appmon's more thoughtful than that. And every other time where there's been something that has happened that's kind of weird, Ray has said, like, hey guys, why are we having filler? We should go fight Leviathan. That's like, who cares if some games are fighting each other and Agumon's coming in and stuff. Leviathan, though.
The big problem for me, and I've brought this up before as sort of why Yujin could not be evil Leviathan robot. And we found out that he is. He's exactly that. He's an android made by Leviathan. He is the host of an artificial intelligence. And he's meant to be some big metaphor about how, like, artificial intelligence will eventually become indistinguishable from humanity, whatever. Honestly, if his name was Yujin Turing, that couldn't hit you over the head with that. He could hit you over the head with that harder.
Yeah.
But I mean, that's what he is.
It's presumably a joke on that, yeah.
But here's the problem to me is that Minerva picked him as an Appli driver. That's how you get a duo. That's why he has a 7 code band, doesn't he?
Yeah, I hope that they explain why Minerva picked him. Because Minerva is... Leviathan is from Minerva, so Minerva should know this kind of thing. She should be aware of what's going on. But to pick Yujin? Unless Minerva is evil.
That's nonsense, because then there's no... If Minerva was evil, then she would never have given them help in the first place, because then they would have just died, right?
Mm.
Why would Minerva have been acting against Leviathan in the first place?
Oh yeah, that's a point. But what I was saying before about my expectations of this being too high is that before we watched the episode, I said, this has to be some amazing thing, because this is episode 47, and this is a mystery that we've known since episode 1, and I feel like if you hold a mystery for that long, it has to be worth it. And I don't think it's worth it, but I think that's my fault, putting too many high expectations in this, because Appmon has previously surpassed expectations and just like, oh no, it's a boring idol episode. Oh wait, no, it made me cry. It's one of the best episodes. Like, it's just, Appmon usually surpasses expectations, but in this episode, it just kind of, I don't know, like, it was disappointing. I know you never put high expectations into Digimon, but...
You know, I mean, the reason I said we should watch this one early is because I didn't want to get spoiled or whatever, and I guess, to me, I was really looking forward to the explanation, because that explanation has to be complicated, and they've put it off for a week, and the worst part about that to me, I think, is that we know the next week they're going to go like, okay, we're in the ending sequence now.
Yeah.
Activate the human app project. And I'm a little afraid they're just not going to cover it.
I'm afraid too, because we have, what, 5 more episodes, I think?
Because it's the sort of thing where, the reason I was fascinated by what was up with Eugene, right, is that there was no good reason for him to be a good guy.
Yeah.
Because he would have just told them. And there was no good reason for him to be a bad guy, because Minerva obviously had vetted him and said he was all right.
Yes.
Which means if you are left in a nowhere land of nothing works, that's a really great place to have your story, but you have to have an ace explanation for it.
Yeah.
And there is a mild possibility that their explanation is, look, he was just an android and you didn't know. And now you know.
I'm going to be mad if that's the case. Because Appmon has previously done so well in so many different respects, like with its characters. I care about every single character in this show. Like, well, out of the main cast. That's never happened in all of Digimon. There's always been a character I'm just like, I don't actually care. Like, I mean, I like them, but I don't particularly love them. But I like all them. I love all the main characters in this. So, I don't know, it's disappointing, and I'm worried that the ending won't, like, I'm worried that the ending will ruin it. I'm worried that the season that has quickly become my favourite season out of all of Digimon, since when I was a kid, I'm enjoying Appmon more than I ever enjoyed Digimon as a kid, and I used to love Digimon, I love Digimon now. Appmon always came, like, is seeming better than that, even better than Tamers, even better than Try, better than any other season of Digimon, and I'm just worried that the ending's gonna ruin that, and it's just going to be another, yeah, it was all right.
I'm thinking at the moment, the only way I can really countenance this is that the 7 Code Band and the Apple Drive Duo, etc. It's weird because he got the Duo first and it has all the functionality.
Yeah.
Because it even does the insertion stuff. And what's he inserting? Because he's a robot.
Himself.
Aren't you USB. Inserting like friendship energy? Can robots have friendship energy?
I don't know.
Okay. Because to me, the only reason that I could think of would be like, okay, well, Leviathan made a fake and it's convincing enough because he's a robot.
Yeah.
And then from there on, I'm like, you know what? Then if that's the case, maybe there's no actual... Offal's not actually a buddy. It's just a guy who's with him.
Yeah.
In which case, he might have actually been the guy with the Apple Drive with Cameramon. Because we still don't know who that was.
Yeah. Or...
And we're never going to know.
What if Eugene was real once? He was a real child when Haru met him. Because, like, you know, it must... I'm pretty sure at the end of the episode you said, how far has this gone on?
How does a robot grow up?
No. I'm just saying, but Eugene was captured because he was close to Haru. And Leviathan, being from Minerva, knows... he saw Haru and said, what's something that's close to him? So
but what Haru he did was... wasn't special then.
No, but what if he already knew that Minerva would get him how? As a protagonist? Because, I don't know, just bear with me, for reasons.
It's a lot of crap what-ifs.
What chooses a Digidestined? I don't know, plot and stuff. But what I'm saying is that what if the fact that Leviathan kidnaps Eugene and turns him into an app, because he needs
he's to test it. He's not an app, he's an android.
No, sorry. Turns Eugene into an app, turns him into Offmon, and removes his memories or something, and then creates an android with an AI, which is Eugene.
I mean, look, I know that the android doesn't really have any more reason to lie at this point, is the thing. And he's straight up because there never was Eugene. He said that.
Okay,
and we also know that his mom's in on it.
I'm just trying to come up with things, okay?
I know, right? I get that. But it's truly nonsense.
Also, the whole human Appmon
project
just reminds me of the human whatever we'll call project in Neon Genesis Evangelion. And we're just doing a Neon Genesis Evangelion.
I don't know what you're talking about.
It's the human something project. It's not Genome. Sure? It's the thing in Neon
Genesis. Can you describe it to me at all? Because I watched that show and there was never anything that turned people into data.
No. It turns them back into the LCL, which is like the liquid, and then they can come back as higher life forms. I used to really like
Neon Genesis Evangelion. Was this in the movies?
No, it was in the show, but they gave up.
I watched the show. Okay,
episode 26, and he's going through all the different realities.
That 26 that is, episodes of that show?
Yes.
I'm pretty sure I watched it all. It all up until they're doing pencil drawings at the end.
Yeah, so in that episode, he goes through different realities, including one where Rey is hyperactive.
I remember the school one.
It's the human... Oh, I had it. Yeah, oh, I forgot what it's called. It's the human something... Oh, I feel really bad because I used to love Neon Genesis Evangelion when I was a kid.
It's okay, didn't we all? I was 21. I was 20.
Yeah, no, it's the Human Instrumentality Project.
Okay.
Which is... And I will get this up so I can read it out because I don't actually remember. All I know is it makes them. That is a lot of reading. Okay.
There's a long term joke where they could have had Shinji break his dad's hip.
It would arise as a result of the third impact, resulting in Lilin's souls being gathered into Leather's eggs, united as a single existence. This would create a state of being for humanity where no individual existed, even identifying this. It still reminds me of it a little bit. Being as a conglomerate, which would be incorrect since there would be no such individual. To achieve this, the flaws in every living would be complemented by the strengths in others, thus filling the gaps and erasing the insecurities in people's hearts. Okay. So it's like a rebirthy thing.
It's quite dissimilar.
It still reminds me of it. I don't know why. I just really like Neon Genesis Evangelion.
It only reminds you, once you said I don't know why, it means I've been reminded of it, and now that I'm wrong, I still remember what I was reminded of.
I feel like there were two sides of it, and one that was... I know, it's all, I don't know. It was a long time.
You just might be wrong.
No. I don't know. Probably.
People who can't accurately justify their stuff even after doing research, generally wrong.
I think that what we know from this is that I have to rewatch Neon Genesis Evangelion.
Yeah, probably.
And not Appmon. I'm so heartbroken.
So yeah, Appmon's almost done.
I am so scared that the ending's going to be bad.
I don't think it'll be bad, but I think that we're going to be left with questions that would be nicer not to have.
Yeah.
I need to know who was operating Cameramon, right? Because
that's the important part.
We really don't know who.
Unless like Eugene just but he said that was his, like, you know, he was new to having an Apple drive because he was like, oh yeah, this is mine, it just showed up. Unless he was lying.
He's been lying about lots of stuff.
Yeah.
But I mean, I tend to think that the correct explanation would have been Naito, but they didn't go with it.
Mm.
So I don't know.
Where is Naito, by the way? He's just off being sad. He's off being sad and not laughing.
Yeah, he's off to get a second PhD or whatever.
Probably. I really need to know, is it Eugen's mum?
I wonder if I'm just stupid. Like, if you looked up like Cameramon on the wiki or something, then they would just say, oh, by the way, this is his Apple driver. Or does he not actually have an? No, but he fused. He has an Apple driver.
We had that. You had the silhouette of the person with the app, and it was. But then they showed it again later on with Mianumon, and they
did they?
Yeah, when she became Wardimon.
I didn't think Wardimon. It was with an Apple drive.
It was. It was an Apple Inc. And we saw it, the silhouette black shadow person again.
Was Eugene there at the time?
No.
I mean, it could be, yeah, but
I hope not.
It'd be stupid.
Well, in the manga, Knight is the Apple driver.
I think that might be it.
But he's not because he... I don't know, I feel like...
No, I honestly think that might be it.
No, the manga's a little bit different.
No, but I think that if... I'm going to look it up. I'm just going to look up Cameramon on the wiki and see if it says he's Apple driver.
Cameramon doesn't show up in the manga, and if he does, he doesn't have an Apple driver.
So who's his... Who's,
I don't know, but
who's his buddy in the... Manga, what?
He's not there.
He has a drive. He has an Apple drive, but no buddy.
I can't remember if he actually even shows up, but if he does, he doesn't become Scopemon. But the thing is, Knight has an Apple drive in the manga.
What?
And he's able to Applink the apps that they fight.
That's dumb.
But I don't think it's Knight, because I feel like they would have told us by now. I think it might be another one. Maybe it's I. We can still say that I might be able. That's
dumb.
I think that she might be maybe brought by Minerva, but I mean, she wouldn't be the Apple driver in that case. We're just like,
what if it's Winston?
No, you mean Watson?
Damn it! No, every time
his friend looks like a hamster. No, it's Caught Up Man.
God no!
Just imagine if it's Caught Up Man though. But no, the thing is, this episode, I can't. It's just...
Okay, the wiki has no answers for me.
That's because there's nothing that's been said yet. Though we don't know who that... It could just be a thematic thing. How salty would you be?
No way.
I'd quit Digimon. I'd quit the fandom.
Oh, I'm so glad. Can it just be nothing, then?
Oh, I'd be so mad. All right, so I placed it in my ranking, but now I've lost my place in the ranking. It's somewhere in my ranking.
Is it sort of below the middle?
Yeah, I think so. So
it didn't make you go.
So yeah, but for the wrong reason. What were you, just any favorite character or miscellaneous parts, or can I go into the ranking now? I found my spot.
I also noticed that Caught Up Man was not here.
Oh yeah, he's not in every episode though. He's not in every, but he's in most of them, I'd say.
He's in most.
So for ranking, I put this above the Ultimate Fierce Fighting Globemon versus Charismon, and below Wake Up Sleepmon, the Appmon Championship reopening. That's like, I think that's in the bottom half, but towards the middle of the list. I don't know. It's just.
Sure.
I feel like when you're writing a final arc, all the episodes should be at the top, because you want to send out the show on a high note, and you want people who are watching the show to feel like the ending was worth watching 50 episodes of something. You don't want salty viewers. You just don't.
It's happening, though. I don't feel super, super positive about it.
So do you have any extra bits? Like, we didn't actually say our favorite characters because I don't think I had one.
It's Eri.
Oh, yeah, I guess, yeah, Eri trying, like, oh, yeah, when she has her, when she tries to surprise him
I'm your sister.
And then Dokumon ruins it for everyone.
What do you mean?
Is that true? No, it's not true. Well, to be fair, she ruined it too.
Of course it's not true.
She didn't have to say, hey, of course it's not true.
I want to find out who...
I know you want to find it out. It's hard to look up.
Oh, you please cover me.
Okay, so Jay's still looking up to see if he can find the answer, but it hasn't been revealed in the thing yet. And there are no... Like, we are up to date. We have not seen the
episode. Unknown Apple driver who maybe has his own... No, oh, I wonder if he has an entry.
What you are reading is all speculation, though, because as I said, we don't know.
Okay, but I mean, what I'm saying is if someone is on... If someone's making a wiki article, right? That means that I haven't missed it. It means that it doesn't exist.
Yeah.
And that's great news.
Yeah, it doesn't exist. We don't know if that who it is or if there is a... I hope it's not for thematic things, as I just mentioned, because that'd be annoying.
What is...
I
don't know. Other humans.
It's probably just Eugen, to be honest.
Is unknown Apple driver a guy? Show me... God, this is so
bad. We don't know anything about the unknown Apple driver. Why is this the one thing that you're like, you want to
know? Caught up old man is his name.
Yeah, it's what he's credited as. He doesn't have an actual name.
I love him. He's the... Oh, my God, he's got such a... He's actually got a really, really long...
Yeah, that's what happens when you're in almost every episode. Jay's just looking through the Wikipedia. This is amazing.
I want to see UMA Hunter Jay again.
I'm leaving this in because you are actually really passionate about Appmon right now.
His entry is Cameramon's buddy?
Yeah.
He's a mysterious Apple driver. They app-fuse. He also app-fuses Mienimon and Sakusimon. And that's it.
Yep.
Okay.
Well done.
Fine.
You know as much as we knew.
I know. It's all the same. But, like, that's a mystery that the show appears to have totally forgotten about.
No, it has not. It's too big. Look, okay. This mystery has to pay off because this is from episode 4.
Well, we thought that Eugen one had to pay off. And it just turned out he was just as evil as we all thought he was. And more evil than Haru was warned about, but he was warned.
Yeah, but this is like, if you would have asked me, so what do you hope's going to happen? What's going to happen? I probably would have said at the very least, this is what's going to happen. He's going to say, I'm a robot, beep boop, and kill someone.
Yeah, pretty much.
I would have said he'd kill Haru because or try to kill Haru because that's how to show you're evil. Kill the cinnamon roll.
Total nonsense, though, because that doesn't accomplish the final goal. And also, he had a million opportunities before this.
I feel like you should have killed Bootmon and Haru because you kill the main character, like you kill the protagonist, you kill the goggle kid.
I mean, I think that's what it's about to do. There is no... robots are weird to write for because if his programming is do thing, there is no reason in the world he would ever be programmed to like, oh yeah, by the way, wait there and explain to Haru what's up. It makes sense for a human character to be like feeling smug, no. But robots don't feel smug.
Jay, this show does seem to have lots of knowledge of science fiction and AIs being written and robots being written.
Yeah.
So surely they'd know that whole robots can't kill people, it's in their programming thing.
Okay.
Like, isn't that a whole paradoxy thing?
Has Leviathan not killed a bunch of people?
No.
A bunch of the apps have, for sure.
Yeah, but not directly. And also, they are the apps, not the robots or AI, maybe?
Look, maybe. But why would Leviathan program Eugen with... Asimov's laws of robotics.
Good point.
Like,
but I still feel like in a kid's show like Digimon, I feel like all humans are safe.
They're all going to get turned into apps, which is kind of killing them.
Yes, but I feel like actual stabby stab death. That's why I made a noise when I thought that he was going to kill Haru. Because I was like, oh my god.
Take him offline.
Though I do think there might be a death in Try. Just because Try seems darker.
Well, Mako isn't in the outro of, in the epilogue.
Because they hadn't planned Try yet in 02.
Yeah, exactly. She's dead.
Yeah, you know, 15 years before they didn't come. They say, hey, do you want to reboot this series in 15 years? Yeah, sure, let's do it.
Obviously. Are we going to make money? Who's going to be still watching our show then? Nobody.
No, people who watch our show now but have disposable income.
Oh my god, a gold mine. Yeah, but it's a it's less than 10% of the number of people. Damn it.
So join us next time for Starting the Design of Humanity Application. Yeah, that's going to be it. Hopefully we get more answers. Hopefully. I'm not going to do it bad and have my hopes up because that went badly. I should never do that.
Did people say this episode was good?
I haven't actually... No, I did not read anything about this episode because every time I saw the words Appmon and 47 together, I would scroll fast.
That's a you turned out you made a mistake.
Yeah, because I was just like, oh my gosh.
We built it up too much in our heads.
The most I read was that was an ending.
Yeah, I mean, it was.
I mean, it was an ending.
It ended the episode. Good on him. That's true.
You can email us at LostinTranslationmon@gmail.com or you can comment on this episode or message us on SoundCloud. You can follow us on @Translationmon on Twitter and you can find us on LostinTranslationmon on Instagram, Tumblr, Facebook, and YouTube. We have a discussion thread on With the Will and a Reddit thread in the Appmon subreddit, and we'd appreciate if you were to review us on iTunes, Stitcher, or whatever podcast listening thing that you use. We also have a website, and you can check out my Apple ranking, which is just filled with my disappointment at the moment. You can donate to our Patreon, which is linked in the description, from as little as $1 a month. $1 a month gets you access to a listener Slack chat group, but higher levels get you exclusive notes, information, early and unedited episode recordings, the ability to suggest discussion topics, Skype calls with May and Jay, and more.
And thank you to our current Patreon supporters, Sam Krieger, who hosts a podcast called The Moncast, which will talk about Pokemon and Digimon, Stevie, who is Stevie Padmon, and they're on Tumblr, and they're currently taking commissions, Ruchinglong, who you can find at twitch.tv/Ruchinglong, Metal Mamemon, Joe, Anime Guy, who is Anime Guy Kurosaki and the number one on YouTube, Penguin Mage, Sharkmon, Ishwal Bamba, Hiro Olado, who is at Hiro Olado on Twitter, Jason Morosky, Ryuchi, who is Frozen Magic on Archive of Our Own, Stephen Reese, who is at WildWing64 on Twitter, Kaidawashi, Mac, Noam, Riku, Chisai, who you can follow at Chisai236 on Tumblr, Corey, Kyle, Delady Bugman, whose anime blog you can find at bagubragu.wordpress.com, Small Wolfie, who is on Topastic at Small Wolfie and has a comic there called Eden of Melancholy, Tom, Glitch Goat, Azra McCool, Nicholas, Gina Hackmon, Matthew, Anthony, who is at AntoClassic on Twitter, Lismet, who is Alekmon on Tumblr, Sithobi, Ellie Vorg, who is Ellie Vorg on Tumblr, Sporky McFlaws and Spoon, Megan, Kaliak, and Neoboo. Sorry.
You can also make a one-off donation on our PayPal, which can be found linked in the description. It's paypal.me/Ergemon. And make sure to let us know for the podcast. See you guys next time. Bye.